Welcome everyone, I'm Ricky from Tech Talk, and today we're taking a look at the Fairphone 3 from Fairphone. And today I want to go through my accessibility settings and options that we're going to find on this device and see how easy they are to use. So let's guide you through and sit back and enjoy the video. By all means, if you have any questions or queries, please drop a comment down below. They'll be more than happy to help. So Fairphone want to design a phone that's fair for you, the consumer. So with a low cost and still including key sort of specs that we need to enjoy our device, from the cameras, the display and the power and performance is all there. So make sure to check out my full review coming up very soon. I've really enjoyed my time with the Fairphone. So the Fairphone 3 offers a large display, which is a 5.65 inch full HD plus display. It means it's bright, it's vibrant, and I can enjoy all of my content, and hopefully so can you. And if you have other abilities, there's other options to change and adjust to make this device easier for you, and try and change and manipulate the device to you. Don't ever change yourself to a device. So that's enough said, let's jump into the accessibility options we find on the Fairphone 3. So first of all, I just want to talk about ease of use. Coming down the left-hand side, you've got your volume controls at the top, and they are split, so making it easier to identify which one is which. They're on a grey to black background, so a grey button to a black background, which is quite helpful and easier to see. Then underneath that, you have your power button, and this is texturally different. So it has some ridges on it, so you can tell which button is which. I think that's a really good thing to see. Being visually impaired, that's really helpful to me. And also, just a general user might even find that helpful. So that's one aspect I did like about it. The device is rugged as well. It's quite strong and rugged, which means it is a little bit more durable compared to some of the devices that are made up of glass. But always just try and be careful, and also use the free sort of bumper that comes with it. So you just slide this over the top. And again, when you see the buttons here, they're slightly different, where it has the rocker button on the side there. So I do recommend using it without that bumper. Then moving on to my second point, I want to talk about ease of access. That's when you're setting up your device. So when you first get your device and you go through the setup process. So as I showed you in my setup process, there's an accessibility section where you can go and change settings and adjust them to yourself. I think that's really helpful. Thirdly, there's another option that we can use before we actually go into the accessibility settings, and that's the volume key shortcuts. So down that left-hand side, press and hold both of them volume keys together. So this message has popped up, and this is saying about use the accessibility shortcut. We actually want to use this shortcut. You can turn it off if you want to. So now we've accepted to use this shortcut, you need to press and hold again.
Talk back on. Talk back is a screen reader primarily for people with blindness and low vision. It allows interaction with the device using spoken feedback. Talk back tutorial.
So now we're on our home screen, but we're actually getting dictation back from Talk Back, which is a service that's from Google, and it's really great to use. Being visually impaired myself, I've used this, and I know I have loads of friends and work colleagues that also use it, and it's very helpful to actually use. So at the top here, there is actually a green box that's highlighted the day and the date, but obviously you can use that then to go to different applications.
Phone, messages, maps, calendar, camera, actions, shortcuts and notifications, remove, move item, double tap to activate, double tap and hold to long press.
So it gives me options there. When you want to gesture and move your way through your device, use two fingers.
Home screen one of one. Home screen one of one.
Okay, so we can go the other way.
Discover. The thrifty rep. Tap to update.
And as you can hear, it makes a sign.
Card menu. Home button. Home screen one of one.
So now when we're back on our home screen, you can also use this up at the top here to find out information about your notifications and also key aspects. So we can select up here.
Vodafone UK. At a glance, 1448. Google Play Store notification, no internet. Phone signal full, battery 79%.
So it will let me know everything I need to know, my key aspects and my key details about my device. TalkBack is a great feature, and I highly recommend having a go if you have a visual impairment or if you want to just navigate your way through your device using spoken feedback. A really great option to have here, and I'm really pleased to see it on this device. So pressing and holding the volume keys together again will actually turn off TalkBack. So TalkBack is now off. So great features out there and I highly recommend. So let's go into settings now. So we're going to swipe up here. We're going to choose the gear icon, which is our settings icon. You can search for accessibility up here at the top, which is a really handy option. I'm really pleased to see that as well. But scrolling down, I just want to show you where it is. So it's in the middle of the section. From the bottom, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 from bottom. It's purple in color and it has a diagram of a statue standing out with its arms and legs apart. So it's called accessibility, and inside here we're going to find all the settings that we can change and modify. So at the top we've got the volume key shortcut option. So inside here you can change and adjust which option you actually want to happen. So as you know, we had TalkBack, but you have color correction, you have color inversion, you have accessibility menu, select to speak, and switch access. So a couple of options to choose there. And again, you have settings that you can go through and change. Also, you can use that on the lock screen. Coming up underneath is the other spoken feedback, which is select to speak. So I'm going to turn this on, and you've got an agreement here. So once turned on, you've got a fourth icon down here at the bottom. So you've got your capacitive touch button. So you've got your back, you've got your home, and you've got your menu option. And now you've got that accessibility statue there again. So if I tap this accessibility statue down here, and then press play.
Navigate up, select to speak, use service, on, settings. When select to speak is on, you can tap specific items on your screen to hear them aloud.
So it read all the way down for me. There's other options as well. So if I tap to dismiss this here, if I stop and dismiss, if I tap again and then actually tap where I want the text to start, so say up here at the top.
When select to speak is on, you can tap specific items on your screen to hear them aloud.
So that means that then it starts where I want it to start. So that can be great for text messages and for when you're going through the internet and reading different documents, also reading news stories. It can be really helpful in that sense as well. Press the stop and this will disappear. Obviously, you can leave that toggled on if you want to, but we're going to toggle it off at the moment because I'm going to toggle on other services that will have the icon come up again. Underneath that, we then have TalkBack. So obviously, I went through the TalkBack options that you have, but also inside here, there's settings that you can change, modify, and make it your own. So you can go through each of these individual settings, making it easier for you to use, and it tweaks and changes the way that you use your device and uses the TalkBack option. Underneath that option, we then have text-to-speech output. So this will change the speech rate and its pitch. So I can actually make it go really fast. So some of you might not actually understand that. I did, so let's slow it down.
This is an example of speech synthesis in English.
Okay, so it makes it a little bit easier. Change the pitch.
This is an example of speech synthesis in English.
And then you can press reset here and it resets for you. Obviously, you can make it slower or make it deeper by toggling around with them two options. But it's really nice that you can change the options inside here. Underneath that, we've got a couple of my other key options that I really do like. One being font size. It's already set to its largest. I do believe it could have went a little bit larger. But it's nice to have that option even here to actually change it. And you have a preview window. So if I slide down, you'll see that preview window getting smaller and the text getting smaller as well to read. Coming back underneath that, we then have display size. So I can actually make this a little bit larger if I want to. It just makes it a little bit easier then to read. And again, we have a couple of presets to actually see that. And also you could make it smaller if you want to. You don't have to always go bigger. Some people prefer it smaller. So there are two great options I really do like. Another option that's really helpful is magnification. Inside here, you have two options. You have magnify with triple tap. So let's go inside here. Once toggled on, three quick taps of the display, and that could be anywhere on the display. That could be the top, the bottom, no matter where it is, corner to corner. Then use two fingers to manipulate your way around the display. And we can go to the top here. We can see Vodafone. You've got the time there as well. You can also pinch into zoom, which I think is a really nice option as well. As it is a large display and a full HD plus display, the text looks clear and sharp for me to read. It just makes it easier for me to use my device. 1, 2, 3 to come back, and then you're back. There is another option where you can quickly jump in. So 1, 2, 3, hold on your third. It remembered the level of zoom you actually zoomed in by. Using one finger this time, we can manipulate our way around our device. And then as soon as I release, we go back. So that's one option there as well. So you have two options inside that one. So coming back, then we have magnify with button. So if I toggle this on, it will bring back our accessibility icon down here at the bottom, like I mentioned. Tap this, tap anywhere on the display, it'll zoom straight in for you. Again, you can use that pinch option to zoom in and out. And then you can use two fingers to manipulate your way around your device. And you can tap that icon again to zoom straight back out. Really nice options to see inside here. Three different ways to magnify, and it just makes it easier reading your device and reading different content. Underneath that, we then have color correction. So we jump inside here, we can toggle this on. And also you can custom mode as well. And you've got three different options to choose here, just depending on your level of different color that you might need to change. But that's a really nice option to see here. Toggle off. And again, this will slightly change and go back to its normal preset options. Underneath that, you have a large mouse cursor, so you can use a mouse cursor with this device to manipulate your way around the device, making it easier if you struggle with interactions with your hands and your fingers. Underneath that, you have the options to remove animations, so the animations don't bother you. It's not too flashy. Everything just works when you need it to work. One other option underneath here is accessibility menu, so I like this option. And then we've got our accessibility icon down here again. But this time, it's not going into one key option. We've got loads of different options to choose from here. And I think this is a really great option. Even if you're on the home screen, we can tap this and then jump straight into an option, which I think is fantastic to see. And again, the accessibility menu offers so many different services, just one tap away instead of going through all the process of jumping into the menu options that I've showed you here. Underneath that, we then have switch access. So switch access offers the ability to use switches in interaction devices with your smartphone. You can connect them up by a USB switch or Bluetooth switch. You can use switches and devices to interact with your smartphone, making it easier for you to use your smartphone at any point, which I think is really important, and I'm really pleased to see that. So I'm actually going to tap exit here and come back. But if you dive into settings, it's unbelievable the amount of settings that Google have provided here for you to change, adjust, and tweak to make your own. I'm really pleased to see that. So there's a really good option there, and I really would like to make a dedicated video on switch access. So underneath switch access, we have dwell timing, and this depends on your interaction as well. So you can change the length of timing. And I think this is a really nice option, quite a new option that we've seen in the accessibility world. And I'm really pleased to see that on here. So you can change how long the action actually takes to actually come true. And again, you can link that with other sections of this accessibility menu. Underneath that, we then have the power button to end calls. So you just toggle that on, and then the power button, which is down the left-hand side with that textured feel, will actually end your calls for you. So that's a really helpful thing to have. You've got auto screen rotate, so once toggled on, bring it around this way, you can then use it this way. But obviously some applications that automatically do this won't need this setting on, it will just happen. So if I toggle this off, it goes back around to its standard format. Underneath that, we then have touch and hold delay, again for interaction and control with your smartphone. You've got short, medium, or long, just depending which options you want to use. And I think that's a really important thing to see here. Underneath that, we have then vibration, and you can change and adjust the vibration for ring and notification, and the touch vibration as well. So I like the haptic touch vibration inside. Really nice option to have as well, especially when I'm using a keyboard. I like to feel that. We then have mono audio. So you can change the audio options here. And then you have captions. You have the ability to use captions from Google. Really pleased to see this on here. Once toggled on, you can change the language. Have multiple different languages. What it might do is just download this language in the background for you. You also have text size, and you have different options of text size, just depending which one is best suited to you. And then also you have caption style, and you have six different styles here to choose from. So for myself, I would go for the yellow text on a black background. So coming back, that's captions there. And again, I've used this before, works really well, and it's really nice to see that on here. Now finally at the bottom, we've got experimental, and you've got high contrast text. So if you toggle this on here, you notice that was green, it is now black, so it changes contrast a little bit for you. So that's all the settings that we found in the device. There's one setting missing that I haven't seen, unless I might have missed it. I did miss it, I do apologize, is color inversion. So color inversion is a great setting that will invert the colors for you, but this will do it system-wide. So when you go home here, it will look really different compared to when its default option is on. So if I toggle this on and then go back home here, you can see the blue background just sort of shows the difference there. It does. I do apologize, I missed that setting. I knew I'd missed it, I was going through in my head, but the color inversion option is inside there, and I'm really pleased to see that. Just before we end the video, they might put some settings in a different section, and this is in display sometimes. Sometimes they hide different things in different sections. So let's go into advanced. So we've got our brightness level, so you can change the brightness. You've got night light, which I think is a great option here. If I turn this on, you'll see the screen start to warm up and get rid of that harsh blue light. That'll protect your eyes when using late at night. And again, once I toggle off there, you'll see it returns to default stage. And again, some options to change and adjust there. You can set a schedule. I think that's really helpful. You also have adaptive brightness that will try and adapt to your lighting and your surroundings around you, which is really helpful as well. So you've got wallpaper, you've got sleep, you've got auto screen rotate again, font size, display size, you've got the network name, you've got screensaver. Coming down to the bottom, just a couple of other options that I want to talk about before we finish. One is being ambient display. So when you receive a notification, it will wake up your screen. So I'm going to toggle that on. And also is device theme as well. So you have a device theme here. So at the moment, it's automatic, depending on wallpaper. We have the light option, or also they offer the dark theme here. So once toggled on, we go home here. If I scroll down, you'll see now this is a dark section where it was white. And again, it's putting some of the settings on side here for me. This won't be system wide, as like some. Normally this goes to a dark theme as well, but obviously it's not system wide. Obviously that might happen with Android updates, which will be coming as always. It's currently running Android 9. I really hope Fairphone adopts Android 10 and push it to the Fairphone 3. I believe it should be able to run, and I will keep you updated in future videos. But that was all the accessibility settings and options that we found on the Fairphone 3 from Fairphone. A really good amount of settings there, the standard sort of settings that we see throughout majority of my videos on accessibility. No new settings, which is a shame. I do like to see a new setting. We got a little bit lost thinking that they might have missed out one setting, but that's okay, we found that. In display, they also offer a load more settings that we went in and found. And if you do have any questions or queries, please do let me know. Thank you always for watching this video, and if you've enjoyed it, please hit subscribe if you haven't already. If you have, thank you very much, and make sure you ring that notification bell to stay updated with all of my latest videos. For me, Ricky, and the Fairphone 3, I'll see you very soon. Bye for now.